أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الذين استجابوا لله والرسول من بعد ما أصابهم القرح للذين أحسنوا منهم واتقوا أجر عظيم. الذين قال لهم الناس إن الناس قد جمعوا لكم فاخشوهم فزادهم إيمانا وقالوا حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. فانقلبوا بنعمة من الله وفضل لم يمسسهم سوء واتبعوا رضوان الله والله ذو فضل عظيم. صدق الله العظيم. الذين استجابوا لله والرسول, those who responded positively to the call of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, min ba'di ma asabahumul qarh, after what infliction had come to them, after they had been badly wounded and inflicted, لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا مِنْهُمْ وَاتَّقَوْا أَجْرُ عَظِيمٍ, for those among them who are the good doers and who have the taqwa and who have Allah's fear, there will be reward, will be unbounded great reward. الَّذِينَ قَالَ لَهُمُ النَّاسُ إِنَّ النَّاسَ قَدْ جَمْعُوا لَهُمْ, those to whom the people said, people have gathered against you, فَخْشَوْهُمْ, fear them, فَزَادَهُمْ إِيمَانًا, but it increased them in faith, in belief. وَقَالُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلُ, and they said, Allah is sufficient for us, and he is the best guardian, and he is the best trustee. فَانْقَلَبُوا بِنِعْمَةِ مِنَ اللَّهِ, so they returned by the mercy of Allah, by the blessing of Allah, وَفَضْلٍ, and his bounty. لَمْ يَمْسَسْهُ سُوءٌ, no harm could come to them. وَاتَّبَعُوا رِضْوَانَ اللَّهِ, and they are the people who are seeking the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَاللَّهُ ذُو فَضْلٍ عَظِيمٍ, and Allah's bounties are unbounded, limitless. These ayat, there are two opinions as to which incident they relate. One opinion is that after the army of Quraysh returned from Uhud, and you know the Muslims, they were very much grieved, 70 had been martyred, many others were badly wounded. But then, you know, the idea came to the mind of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that maybe that the kuffar think and we think, you know, that why have we come back? They might think of coming back again and invading Medina. So better it would be that we chase them to show that we are, you know, we have not given in, and we have not given in our hearts. They are there and we can chase them, and we are ready even now to fight them. So he called, he gave the command, Muslims, be ready. We have to chase this enemy. So many of the Sahaba, you know, they in that condition also, that condition of grief, and they were wounded and so on, but they responded to the call of Allah, because the call of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam was call of Allah. So they responded, they went there for quite a long distance. And it did come to their knowledge that really it happened that Abu Sufyan had the second thought, and he was thinking of coming back to Medina and invading Medina. But when the news came to him that Muhammad is chasing him, so he was frightened like anything and he ran away. So one opinion is that these three ayat relate to this incident. The other opinion is that when Abu Sufyan returned from Uhud, he said loudly, our next round will be next year at Badr. We had have a round at Badr 1 year before. Now we have avenged ourselves. You killed our 70 people, we have avenged. We have taken the revenge. Now the next round, we shall meet again at Badr. Now when that time came, the Prophet ﷺ gave the call, O Muslims, we have to accept their challenge. Come on, we go to Badr. The Prophet went to Badr, again along with the companions. Many people brought the news that the kuffar have gathered a very big number of people, and they are coming in a very big force. But you know, the Muslims, when they listen to it, they said, Hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel, Allah is sufficient for us. So Muhammad and his men, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, they waited at Badr for so many days, but Abu Sufyan couldn't take the courage to come to Badr and fulfill his challenge. So these two incidents, you know, the wordings of the ayat cover both, and there are opinions regarding both incidents. Now you just hurriedly again translate. Alladheena stajabu lillahi wa rasool, those who called, those who responded positively to the call of Allah and His Messenger, min ba'd ma asabahumul qarb, after that infliction had come to them, they had been wounded badly. Lilladheena ahsanu minhum wattaqu ajrun azim, for those of them who had the real iman and real taqwa, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give them very great reward. Alladheena qala lahumun nasu inna an-nasa qad jama'u lakum, those to whom people said that your enemy, the Quraysh, they have gathered a very big army for you. Fakhshawhum, you must have fear of them. Fazadahum imana, but to these mu'mineen, these bad news also, they couldn't break their courage, their will to fight. Rather, it increased in their faith and belief. Zadahum imanam waqalu hasbunallahu wa ni'mal wakeel, and they said, for us Allah is sufficient, His help is sufficient, and He is the best in whom one can put his trust. Fanqalabu, so they returned, fanqalabu bi ni'matin min Allah, by the blessings of Allah, wa fadlin, and His bounties. Lam yamsathum su, no bad thing, no harm could even touch them. But tabau ridwanallah, they definitely followed and they sought the pleasures of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wallahu zul fadl al-azim, and Allah is definitely has great bounties. His bounties are unbounded, unlimited.